The meaning of Islam. When Allah says, this is the only one way of life that is accepted in my sight. We know, if you have a little knowledge of Arabic, Islam comes from the root Arabic word salam, meaning peace, and it also derived from the Arabic word silm, which means to submit. In short, Islam means acquire peace by submitting the will of the individual to the will of the Creator. And the will of the Creator is the glorious Quran. And the Quran also emphasizes to obey the commandment of the last and the final messenger, Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him. So, if any Muslim come across a single authentic narration of the Prophet Islam, it is obliged upon every Muslim, he should follow that. That is what is Islam, to acquire peace by submitting our will to the will of the Creator, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And in the same surah, same chapter, chapter 3, Surah Al-Imran, verse 85, Allah the Almighty is put forwarding a straightforward message to mankind, that وَمَنْ يَبْتَغِ غَيْرُ الْإِسْلَامَ دِينًا فَلَا يُقْبَلَ مِنْهُ, meaning that if any human being prefer to choose any other way of life other than Islam, فَلَا يُقْبَلَ مِنْهُ, it will never and ever accept it from them. وَهُوَ فِي الْآخِرَةِ وَمِنَ الْخَاسِرِينَ, and in the hereafter, in the Day of Judgment, they will lose all the spiritual blessings. They will lose the paradise. This is a straightforward message by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Now, we wanted to know what will happen to the others. There are billions of people in the world today. And out of 6 billion people approximately, 1.5 billion are assumed to be Muslim. But what will happen to the rest of the 4.5 billion? Majority of them are Christians, minority of them are Jews, some are Hindus, some are Buddhists. What about the others? So now let us see through the facts and the figures that we can derive from the authenticity of the religious scriptures, what will happen to them? Islam is very clear, if anyone does not follow the religion of peace, that is Islam, submitting the will to the will of the Creator, he will be lost in the hereafter. In the world today, as I say, there are two types of religion. If we divide the world religion into major two types, there are few major world religion and there are minor religions. In major religions, it makes a list like Christianity, their adherents are 2.1 million, billions. Islam occupies the second rank in the world in number of practice, 1.5 to 1.6 billion. And there are Hindus, 1.3 or 1.1 billion. There are Buddhists and there are Jews, approximately 13.1 million. And there are also other followers like Zoroastrianism, Sintoism, and there are many, many religions like atheism, humanism. And you will be amazed to know one of the names of one religion is Confucianism. The purpose of this religion is to confuse the people. So there are also Confucianism. Though their followers are very minor, but yet there are religions like that. These are considered to be the major world religion. There are also minor religions like Sintoism, Taoism, Jainism. People from China, there are minor sects. In Japan, Taoism is practiced, Sintoism is also Chinese origin. Very few minor, because the majority of the people on that region, they practice Buddhism. So these are the major world religions. And how this differentiation of the religions comes from? If you go back to the history, we know Prophet Noah, Hazrat Nuh alayhi salam, as we Muslims say, Prophet Noah, as the Christian Bible says, that he had few sons. One of his sons' name is Shem. And from his name, the followers of Shem call the Semitic religion. They are the Semites. And there are other groups who does not follow the belongs to the followers of Shem. The son of Hazrat Nuh alayhi salam, his name is Shem. Shem. In Hebrew, you can say Shem. So there are Semitic religion, there are non-Semitic religion. Semitic religion are the followers of Hazrat Nuh alayhi salam. And there are three religions falls under the category of Semitic religion. That is Judaism, Christianity and Islam. Because these are the religion people claim to be the religion of the prophets. We know Prophet Moses, peace be upon him, he came long before Hazrat Muhammad Islam, Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, and long before Jesus Christ, peace be upon him. And that is what the people in the world will tell you, that he brought up this religion of Judaism. So Judaism is a prophetic religion. Christianity, as the Christian claim, that Hazrat Isa alayhi salam supposed to bring this new religion, that is called Christianity. That is their claim. And Islam is also a prophetic religion, as we Muslims believe that this is the only one religion was sent to humanity from the first man, Hazrat Adam alayhi salam, till the last and final messenger, Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him. All of these prophets, beginning from Hazrat Adam alayhi salam, Prophet Noah, Abraham, peace be upon him, Moses, Jesus, Muhammad, David, Solomon, all of these prophets, may Allah be pleased with them all, they are the prophets of Islam. They are the true prophets of God Almighty, and they bring only one religion, and that is Islam. What is Islam? The will of God. And all the prophets, they were given certain messages by God Almighty, and they speak to the people so that people can lead a good and peaceful life according to the commandment of God. And that was the religion. Now let us define the subject. Judaism or Christianity or Islam. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given us the Muslims a responsibility by giving a direct directions. How to speak to the people of the other scriptures. And it is mentioned in the Quran, the sacred books of the Muslims, in chapter 3, Surah Al-Imran, the same surah, verse 64, Allah says, "Qul, tell to the people with whom, Ya Ahlal Kitab, O people of the book," referring especially here to the learned men of the Jews and the Christians, because they are holding the books. The learned men of Christians, not the ordinary men that we see in the street who don't know anything about religion. But the Quran is specifically addressing the people who have certain knowledge about their religion, referring to the Jews and the Christians, what we Muslims are supposed to do with them. So Allah says, Ta'alaw, tell them to come. What for? Have a tea? Have refreshments? Not for. Yes, that falls after, but first, things Allah wants us to open our mouth by telling that Allah na'budu illallah. You invite them to way of Allah by telling that we worship none but only one Almighty Creator who creates you and who creates me. Wala nushrika bihi shay'an, and we associate no partner with the God Almighty. Wala yattakhiza ba'duna ba'dan arbaban min dunillah, and we choose not among ourselves lords and patriots other than Allah. فَإِنْ تَوَلَّوْا, then the Quran given an instruction that if these people, they don't receive or they don't accept what you say, فَقُولُوا أَشْهَدُ بِأَنَّا مُسْلِمُونَ, don't get